Welcome. My name is Lucy and I'm a fine art beader. I've had a brilliant couple of days. I've been part of a two-week exhibition and the last couple of days I have been demonstrating beadwork. So, beading by hand. And also beading on these two looms. And I was especially pleased because a few people, after seeing my work in the show, actually came back to see what I did and how I did it. So that was absolutely fantastic. And I've also been invited to do some talks on the topic. So I'm so thrilled, I'm so chuffed. It's amazing. And I just love telling people about it and explaining it to them and sharing what I do. So that's brilliant. So today I thought I would start a short series on a tool called BeadTool, which is specially designed so that you can make your own patterns for beads. Okay, and I've had a number of questions around BeadTool already, so I thought I would cover them off in a very short series. So I'll put them all into one playlist and you can access the elements that you actually want to hear about. So I thought first of all I would talk about why I've chosen BeadTool to use at the moment, and I will also review at a later date the online Miyuki BeadTool as well, and all the pros and cons of both of these tools. I will then talk about starting a project, saving it, and the basic steps in producing your pattern and your project, and I will take you through the process of putting together this dog rose pattern so we can actually go through something together. I'll also talk about importing pictures because that's an absolute breeze and such a time saver, absolutely brilliant. And also I'll talk about the stamp tool in another edition. With a stamp tool you can move different parts of the pattern around, and you can also copy and paste parts of your pattern around. So if you want to extend your pattern, it's really, really simple to do. I might talk about the technical side of things in terms of sizing. So if you need to get something to a particular size, then it's really important to know how to do this, so you don't waste your time and energy beading something up that doesn't fit. And I think I'll talk about printing out your pattern, because it can be a bit of a challenge sometimes, and there's ways of getting around it and dealing with it. So I'll do a section on printing. And then I'll do the Miyuki online tool for comparison. So moving swiftly on, why did I choose BeadTool in the first place? Well, first of all, I have to say I'm not associated with BeadTool in any way. So I'm just going to tell you how it is for me. Okay, first of all, price. It's not as expensive as some other bead tool pattern making devices. Some other ones have lots and lots of bells and whistles, but I felt that I didn't actually need them. And most importantly, some of them didn't work on an iMac. So I needed something that works on an iMac or Apple, and this one certainly does. You have a great option of downloading a trial version. So I'd recommend, if you're thinking about this, to do that. Obviously it's hobbled, so you can't save a pattern, but you can certainly get a lot of testing done on it and see if it works for you. It has palettes of beads, certainly by Miyuki and Toho, and they have the reference numbers and the descriptions, the names of the beads, so you can actually go and buy the right beads for your pattern that you've developed, so that's great. And I tend to use those Japanese Miyuki and Toho beads because they're best for bead weaving, I find, anyway. When I first started, of course, I was into the pen and paper, which was really laborious and time-consuming. Fun to do, but very time-consuming. Then I moved on to the computer and I was using things like Excel and trying to work things out on that. It really doesn't cut it. So when I changed and went on the BeadTool and found things so easy, I could literally paint and draw on screen, and there was my pattern, I could print it out, absolutely glorious. And then importing the picture, absolutely, it was a breeze. It also has a selection of stitches to choose from, so that's really, really helpful. And you can save your patterns to your computer, other online tools. You don't tend to save your patterns to the computer. It sort of works slightly differently. So to me, it was a no-brainer. Rather than spending hundreds of pounds or hundreds of dollars on a tool that wasn't going to work for me anyway, I thought I would get something that was perfectly functional and really good and time-saving at a fraction of the cost. So that drove me to use BeadTool predominantly for my patterns and designs. Very, very simple to use. So next time I'm going to talk to you about starting a project. We're going to do a dog rose together, and how to start a project, how to save it, and how to just create it and paint it, and a few good things around that. So do join me next time in this series. See you soon. Don't forget to subscribe and share and like and tell all your friends. Okay, see you soon.